Hello everyone and welcome to Van Tech Corner. Recently, I upgraded my Linksys WRT1900AC V1 to the latest OpenWrt stable release, the OpenWrt 22.03. After upgrading, I noted that the throughputs were hugely reduced. Before this, I had no problem getting gigabit throughput with a 1-2 LAN test. Now, I only get a maximum speed of 350 Mbps download and 750 Mbps upload with OpenWrt 22 or 23. In this video, let's take a closer look at the throughput and see how I managed to fix that. Actually, I upgraded the Linksys WRT1900AC to OpenWrt 21 some time ago. At that time, my internet plans were just 300 Mbps and I didn't note any problem when running the speed test. Recently, I installed a new fiber line and it's for gigabit internet or 1000 Mbps throughput, which you will get around maximum 940 Mbps with a gigabit internet port. The ISP runs PPPoEs and here is the configuration on OpenWrt. They publish IPv4 and IPv6 address. I have also turned on packet steering and shortwave uploading to get the highest throughput possible. Unfortunately, the speed test result is terrible. The CPU either is 22% or 78% CPU load to handle 330 Mbps download. We can see that the load is on two cores of the CPU, so it shouldn't be a problem with IRQ. To make sure the speed test result is correct, I run another test and the result is the same. Besides PPPoE, DHCP is also not working fine. This time, the download speed is better, it is 780 Mbps, while the upload speed is struggling at 660 Mbps. I have downgraded the router to OpenWrt 21 and run the test again, of course with packet steering and shortwave uploading enabled, but the throughput is not improved. So, I tried to downgrade the Linksys WRT1900AC to OpenWrt 19, where we have swconfig instead of DSAs on OpenWrt 21 and onwards. However, after a few attempts, it is impossible to downgrade from OpenWrt 21 to OpenWrt 19, even if I have selected force upgrades on the LuCI web interface. There is still another way, which is reverting the Linksys WRT1900AC V1 to the stock firmware and then install OpenWrt 19. It sounds like a good plan, so I give it a try. It is very simple to revert the WRT1900AC to stock. You just need to download the stock firmware to the TMP directory using wget. After that, use system array command to install the firmware. The guide can be found on the OpenWrt TOH page. The whole process will take around 5 minutes. After that, the WRT1900AC is reachable at 192.168.1.1 with Linksys stock firmware. The Linksys WRT1900AC is running stock firmware for now. Let's install OpenWrt 19 on it. First, let's go and get the OpenWrt firmware from downloads.openwrt.org. Then, go to connectivity to manually upgrade the router. After a few minutes of waiting, the WRT1900AC V1 is up and running with OpenWrt 19. Now, I will configure the PPPoE on OpenWrt. Let's go to Network Interfaces, switch to tag the VLAN for the WAN port. For this setup, my ISP runs PPPoEs on VLAN 35. Here, the WAN port and the CPU Ethernet 1 are tagged with VLAN 35. Let's go to the network interfaces to set up the WAN interface. Very good, the interface is up and running. Let's have a speed test before enable shortwave offloading. The speed is 216 Mbps for download and 787 Mbps for upload. Let's enable shortwave offloading and give it a try. This time, the download speed reached 770 Mbps and the upload speed reached 893 Mbps. Let's open top and edge top to see the CPU utilization when the speed test is running. We can see that the CPU load is 90% at 815 Mbps download. For upload, it is reaching close to 900 Mbps with 65% CPU load. I have also configured the ONU to tag the VLAN in order to test the PPPoE connection with no VLAN tagging. You can see that the swconfig is defined with the one port untagged, Ethernet 1 tagged with VLAN ID 2. This time, we got 93% CPU load for 800 Mbps download. For upload, the CPU load is around 64 Mbps at 890 Mbps throughput. The result remains the same for the second and the third test. We can see that by going back to OpenWRT19 where swconfig is still being used, the Linksys WRT1900AC performs better than its worlds on OpenWRT 21, 22, and 23, where the new DSA is being used. Anyway, this is just my personal opinion and solution. If you have any idea to get a better throughput in OpenWRT 22 or OpenWRT 23, please share in the comment section. That is all for this video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.